A foot in my mouth and other odd imperial idiosyncrasies. Usually, I discuss topics related to the Carolina Bays, but this presentation is about measurements and ambiguities. One of the great achievements of mankind was the development of writing. The ability to write really distinguishes humans from other animals. Before the invention of writing, people relied on stories told by elders who remembered what had happened before. These oral traditions were sometimes preserved as poems or songs that could be retold more accurately because the rhyme or the music imposed a linguistic structure. But writing did not solve all the problems of communication. Today we still struggle with words and their meaning. A stream of consciousness can reveal very unusual associations. Take the word pea, P-E-A, for example. It is a tasty legume from which we can make pea soup. But watch out for homophones. The word pea, P-E-E, meaning urine, has the same pronunciation, and suddenly, pea soup does not sound that appetizing. The plural of pea is peas, like two peas in a pod, but peas with two E's is the third person plural of the verb pea, which brings us back to the bathroom. But wait, peace is a calm state of being, but spelled as peace, P-I-E-C-E, it is just a part of the whole. While peace is usually an uncountable noun with no plural, the plural of peace is pieces. And who is on first? All this confusion makes me put on my thinking cap, which supposedly increases brain power by at least 50%. Nevertheless, I managed to put a foot in my mouth. And this brings us to the topic of measures. From time immemorial, people use their feet and their hands to measure their tents and the heights of their horses. Tall people always complained that short people had smaller feet and that the measurement of their tents in feet was exaggerated. To avoid arguments, standard measures were developed. The metric system was first proposed by the French astronomer and mathematician Gabriel Mouton in 1670 and was standardized in France in the 1790s. It is a decimal measuring system based on the meter, liter, and gram. The meter was originally defined as 1/10,000,000th of the length of the meridian arc from the North Pole to the equator. The system uses Greek and Latin prefixes as quantifiers. A kilometer is 1,000 meters. A millimeter is 1,000th of a meter. The metric volume measures are derived from the meter. A volume of 1 liter is defined as 1,000 cubic centimeters. The weight measures were originally defined from the volume measure and the properties of water. 1 kilogram was defined as the weight of 1 liter of water at the maximum density of water, which is about 4 degrees Celsius. A couple of things went wrong during the definition of this system, but the errors were not discovered until more accurate measuring techniques were developed. It turned out that the meter that had been used for some time was not exactly 1/10,000,000th of the length of the meridian arc from the North Pole to the equator. The meter is currently defined in terms of the speed of light in a vacuum, so the prototype meter bars that were so useful in the past are no longer needed. The second problem of the metric system stemmed from the determination of the maximum density of water, which affected the weight measure. The modern definition of the kilogram is now based on a specific numerical value of the Planck constant instead of the previous weight prototype kept in a vacuum. The metric system is used as the official system of measurement throughout the world, except in the United States, Liberia, and Myanmar. Even England, from which the imperial measures of feet, pounds, and ounces originated, has adopted the metric system. It is ironic that all the imperial measures are now defined in terms of metric units. The imperial system has several ambiguities today. There are 2 miles. A nautical mile is used in air, marine, space navigation, and for the definition of territorial waters. Today, the international nautical mile is defined as exactly 1,852 meters. The derived unit of speed is the knot, which corresponds to 1 nautical mile per hour. The second mile is called the statute mile, and it has a length of 5,280 English feet, or exactly 1,609.344 meters. The distance between New York and Los Angeles is 4,488 kilometers. If we go by air, that is 2,423 nautical miles, but if we go by car, that is 2,788 statute miles. Could this ambiguity cause any problems? Nah, everything is just fine. We will just take an airplane and travel fewer miles. Another troublesome imperial unit is the ounce. The question here is whether you want a drink or whether you want to weigh something. 1 US fluid ounce is 29.5735 milliliters. I will drink to that. However, if you want to weigh something, you have to know whether you are weighing precious metals or ingredients for your cake. The avoirdupois ounce is used to measure packaged foods, food ingredients, and postal items. 1 avoirdupois ounce is exactly 28.34952312.5 grams. Those 9 significant figures are necessary to assure that the errors of conversion are always less than the accuracy of the scales. The troy ounce is used to weigh precious metals such as gold, silver, and platinum. 1 troy ounce is exactly 31.1034768 grams. The troy ounce is 2.76 grams heavier than the avoirdupois ounce. This is interesting. Copper is in the same column of the periodic table as gold. Is it precious enough to weigh it as troy ounces? It is somewhat embarrassing that the United States, being a world leader in technology, is the only industrialized country that has not officially transitioned to the metric system. Some progress is being made. Many drinks in the United States, such as water and soda, are bottled in metric containers. Most scientific work in the United States is done using the metric system in order to share new discoveries with the rest of the world.